Good morning, I am Kevin Price. Delighted to be with you after my whirlwind visit to Vegas, in and out rather fast. Spent all the time I wanted to spend and about 24 hours more. Hey, that was how long I was there. Anyway, we'll talk a little bit more about my trip to Vegas. I did have a great time interviewing an individual I think is a thought leader in the energy industry, but we'll get into that later on in the program. Right now, I'm going to be spending some time with a gentleman I consider a thought leader in his industry. I've got time here with the CEO of Netrepid, Sam Coyle. He's a regular contributor here on The Price of Business, does a fantastic job of bringing us some excellent talent and information from the world of business. Sam, as always, welcome to the program. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your company and then introduce your guest today?
Sure. Good morning, Kevin. Netrepid is a national provider of virtual hosting and cloud services out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. I've been around for about 10 years, focusing on providing those IT infrastructure needs to the mid-market and large market clients. Today, I have one of a good friend of mine, Chris Tanner. He's the director of e-commerce at Bowman Hat Company, and he's been doing some really neat things with e-commerce, and I thought I'd be a good person for us to talk to this morning.
Very cool. By the way, Netrepid can be found at Netrepid, Netrepid.com. Chris, welcome to the program. I looked at your site. I liked your site a lot and was really enjoying the hats.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Yeah. Kind of tell us your story.
I work for, I'm the director of e-commerce for Bowman Hat Company. We've been in business since 1868. We carry some of the largest lines of hats and manufacture about 10 different hat brands that we're responsible for. We have offices all over the world, and we employ about 300 people here. So my direct responsibilities are for managing the e-commerce side of things and all of the websites for Bowman Hat Company.
Sam, your question?
Yeah, Chris, we talked a little bit earlier, and you guys have gone through some major changes on the e-commerce site. I thought maybe you could tell us a little bit about what led you to your current situation with the technology and how you guys come up with your platform.
Sure. When I came on board to Bowman Hat Company back in August of last year, they were on a platform, an e-commerce platform that was kind of stagnant and didn't allow a lot of customization or the ability to manipulate things. And as we know, e-commerce is constantly changing. So the ability to do that was very important to us. We have a small staff here in the e-commerce department, about 6 people, and it's very important that we were able to make changes kind of constantly as things change daily. So we switched over to Magento Enterprise, started that process in January of this year, and wrapped it up in April. So a very tight timeline. There were some challenges, obviously, in bringing that information over to a new platform, but we've been very happy with the ability to kind of manage the sites on our own now without having to go to the e-commerce platform carrier.
Chris, how large is your whole organization?
I'm sorry?
How large is the organization of the whole company?
300 employees.
300 employees. Interesting. Go ahead, Sam.
Obviously, when you're hosting a website of this magnitude, you guys are getting thousands of hits and lots of transactions. The discussion becomes, do you keep this in-house and try and build your own infrastructure to run it and to maintain it, or do you outsource it? Maybe you can kind of talk about what your selection was and what led you to that decision process.
Sure. We've always outsourced our websites as far as the hosting side of it. Early on when we started this back in our online presence back in 2004, we did have a custom application built for us. And I think the reason that our company and a lot of other companies are going to a more managed type of solution, especially from a hosting standpoint, is because it is such an undertaking to bring that in-house and requires such an infrastructure and so many employees to manage and maintain that and to be able to keep up with what's happening in technology. So that was one of the reasons why we are hosting outside of internal. And then also the platform, being that it is a robust platform and has been around for a while and has some very big support through eBay and its parent company, we felt that was the best choice for us because it gave us flexibility and also gave us a platform that we can grow with.
Interesting. So I would imagine with a company with the age, if you will, of yours, moving into a more modern paradigm of commerce must have been really challenging.
Yeah, very much so. I mean, we're definitely still struggling with that, you know, getting past the point of, you know, that old school mentality and moving to kind of the new way to sell products online. And even though we've been doing it since 2004, again, it's constantly changing. So we have to, you know, make sure that we're keeping up with that, those processes and those things that are changing as well. So,
yeah, before I have Sam ask the next question, I want to make sure we get your website in. Chris, go ahead and give that.
Sure. It's www.hats.com. And we have the largest selection of hats online. So.
Wow, very cool. Go ahead there, Sam.
Hey, Chris, I'm obviously doing all the credit card transactions. There's elements of security and confidentiality that come into place. How do you guys deal with things like PCI compliance and managing that confidential information and still provide the quality services that you are?
Sure. You know, when we went through this process of switching over, we certainly made sure that we were audited and had things in place, using outside companies to come in and tell us, you know, to make sure that we were doing things correctly. I think anybody that would be taking on this large a scale of credit card transactions would need to or want to have, you know, an outside firm that specializes in that. We're not experts in that, so having them come in and tell us, you know, here's what you need to do, here are the things that need to take place. And also the companies that we work with, Authorize.net and some of those others, are all PCI compliant. And we made sure that was the part of our process as we were moving forward.
Chris, one more time, give your website.
Sure, it's hats.com, www.hats.com.
That should be easy to remember. And, of course, we need to have Sam, as we wrap it up, any final thoughts before we let you both go?
I just love to you know, hear about the e-commerce side and where you guys think the next big piece in the e-commerce is for you and your organization.
Okay. Well, our you know, as we put together our 5-year plan for the websites, you know, the big initiative that we see as probably our biggest potential growth is mobile. You know, we've seen a significant increase in mobile traffic, obviously with smart devices and tablets. So we really see that in the next 5 years as being our big selling point, and we're putting things in place now to make that a reality.
All right, great interview, great segment. Sam Coyle, he is a regular contributor here on The Price of Business, and you can learn more about his company at Netrepid.com, and Chris Kenner, and he's with Hats.com, and our guest today. Thanks to both of you gentlemen.
Thank you.
All right, when we come back, much more for you. Do want to remind you, best content here shows up over there at usdailyreview.com. You're listening to The Price of Business.